Hey guys, what's up, man? This is Dr. Matt bringing you another all-new training video, guys. I'm not going to do a whole lot of talking throughout the workout, right here at the beginning of the workout, guys. We're going to get rolling in like a minute, but I'm going to do a lot of talking throughout. I'm here with a couple of my awesome clients, Greg and Summer, along with Jade, which is usually behind the camera, but now her second youngest daughter is behind the camera. Verity, so she's gonna be videotaping, guys. You're gonna get a look at the entire workout today, not just a part of it that usually goes on repeat and you guys can piece it together and extrapolate. Like, this is gonna be everything from start to finish. So you guys are gonna see a lot of repetition, how things roll, really catch a glimpse of like the flow of a training session. We basically are looking at like a 35-minute protocol, a couple big blocks. So this video is going to come to you guys in two parts. Okay, I'm going to give you a part one and a part two, which is just the first and second half of this workout, guys. So like I said, I'll talk it up throughout, guys, and you'll see how we get this thing rolling in 10 seconds. You good, Jade?
Yeah.
Summer, you good? 8 total reverse lunges. Summer, your goblet position. So guys, we're kicking this off right here. Barbell alternate reverse lunges, 8 total. And guys, keep it nice and straight. That's 8 total, great. Good job, man. Nice. 8 total reverse lunges. Don't overwork. Okay, deadlift, swing. Summer, did you get it?
Yes.
Yep. Okay, deadlift, swing to 12 total. Touch the floor every time with it, guys. 1 to 1. Perfect, guys. Hey, 46 seconds of rest. Load increase rate if you got it. Good stuff. So set one right there, guys. Now I'm just increasing my load. We are gearing up to do 10 sets of lunges, trying to find a max load, guys. A max load. Good. Base. 8 total. 8 total. In 6 seconds. You can stay there if you want there. Coming up, guys. Second set. Still 4 each leg. Boom. Second set. 8 total. Deadlift swing, okay? Stay right there, bear, I'll face you. So second and final set. Deadlift swing, 1 to 1. To 12, guys. Reverse lunge set. Across the 10 sets, I want to try and find a max set and at the very least stick there for the rest of my 10 sets, okay? So right here with a 25-pound bar, I'm at 135 here, ramping up the load, guys, trying to find my max in 10 sets, working more speed-based stuff after every set of lunges. Guys, 6 seconds, blocks open. And we're working, guys, in a minute, 45 second intervals right here. You good, Greg?
Yep.
8 total, let's do it. Third set. double arm squats on these guys with the dumbbell for 12. Summer, you're killing it. You good?
Good.
Okay. Double arm squats on 12 strong, guys. Get it and rest. Alternatives to kettlebell-based exercises that you can do with dumbbells. Guys, we have 40 seconds. This is an example, guys. I don't need a kettlebell to do double arm squat swings. Boom, one dumbbell, grip it up, find what works for you in terms of the placement, grip it up strong, and I've got my squat swings there. Making another load increase. We're coming up on set 4 of our lunges. Every 2 sets, guys, I'm changing my speed-based work with the dumbbell. Every 2 sets, like I said, writing out 10 straight sets here in that flow, guys, 7 seconds. We good? You good? Great job. And 8 lunges, here we go. Nice job, great. Great thing about a protocol like this, we've got 30 seconds, guys. Great thing about a protocol like this is it's all about how you feel for that day. If you feel like a beast, then you're making load increases every set. If you hit a wall and you plateau, you ride it out and you keep your form strict and you take it on through. Guys, we have hinge swings next, okay? Every 2 sets, changing the dumbbell movements. You guys will see a new one coming up here. 5 seconds. Still though, sticking with 8 total lunges. Great, great job, man. This set. Wider, guys, in my normal RDL stance, but I'm coming up with an RDL type motion with my swing. You've seen this with the kettlebell. Hips back, chest down, RDL motion. Swing through. Starting to feel the fatigue, guys. We're coming up, you know, 35, 40 seconds of rest. That's a fairly long time for our group in here. Nice, 8 total, guys. Set 6. Guys, for the last time. Whew. Yeah,
guys are getting a show from the front. 12 again, guys, 12 again. RDL motion, hips back, chest down. Nice, guys, we got the two dumbbell work coming next. Get it right here. Oh, good stuff. Set seven, guys. 30 seconds. Whew. Still making the increase, feeling good. Really starting to feel the potentiation coming from a heavy set like this to a much lighter dumbbell set. Don't really start to feel that until these loads really start to get max. I'm at 185 right now on the lunges and just working about 35% of my body weight or so with a 70 pound dumbbell and a pair of 35s right here. Nice job, guys. Set seven. Still 40 seconds on the lunges. Whew. Swing. Whew. Gotta widen up out these two dumbbells. You guys have seen me do this with kettlebells and with a narrow stance. Now coming in wide, having a dip. Whew. Swing. 12 total. Nice, Summer. Nice, Greg. So like Greg has told me, he's maxed out at this load, which is great. So he's gonna stick there. We've still got three more sets left. It's all about form. It's all about your max load in the context of this workout. It's fast. It's, you know, people are like, oh, I squat way more than that, or I lunge way more than that. It's like, well, you get in the context of a workout like this, and maybe you won't, because we're really pinning in on strength, endurance, pushing the pace, and then having to fight fatigue in these max loads. Here we go. Eighth set, guys. Come on. Yeah. Lunges here. Guys, good job. Feeling it now. Notice though, guys, other than maybe the speed of my movement right there, form staying strict, chest is upright, trunk's really locked in. Good job. Yeah, your finger's not in the camera, is it?
No. No.
Make sure your trunk's locked in, guys. Getting that nice light knee kiss and driving through. Nice, guys. Two more sets. Here we go. You gotta lock your trunk in with this bar, guys. Nice light kiss, push through, single limb power. Already able to an alternate single arm swing, guys, to finish. Ooh. Oh. Dude, I'm getting a glute cramp. I can feel it. Yeah, hit that side angle right there. That's perfect. Good job, guys. 12 total. It's an RDL right here now. Instead of a squat, having to groove down. Boom. Pop through and out. 12 total. Glutes. Squeeze. Seconds. I think I'm gonna do it right here. Throw a five on it.
Yeah.
Oh man. Last set, guys. Coming up. 10th and final set. Load ramp, max load. This will be my max load right here. Gotta really focus in on this type of stuff. Form. Break it up if you need to. Never compromise form under loads like this. Down, driving up and out, down, really heavy use my posterior chain to drive through. That was the 10th and final set. Worked up. Shit, guys, great job. Be getting some water here. This is a good time where we really get to like our branched chain amino acids, or at the very least hydrate. And you see I always got my jug. So halfway point of the workout right here. We've got a second half. It's gonna be that same idea, same madness. And we're gonna switch up the exercise battery. So here though, 65, 85, 205, I went, just to ramp up, guys, I started at 95 pounds. And I think as soon as I got to, I made 20 pound jumps to 155. Then I started to break it down with just 10 pound jumps. And I went 65 all the way up to 215. And that right there I could feel, given this fatigue level, going any heavier, I might have lost my form, you know, lost it in my back. Got a knee kiss every time. And as you can see across sets, significantly heavier from my first to my last. But form and quality staying there and working it back and forth, guys. That's basically all lower body. And you'll see in the second half, it's the same thing. All lower body coming up in this fast-paced lift, guys. Minute 45 blocks where we're having to get everything in, find whatever rest we have left, utilize it, make our load change, and then go from there. Stay tuned, guys. I got part 2 coming up for you next. Thanks for watching this part 1.